to let people in, and we'll get started. So tonight is all about mindset, motivation, and motivation. Okay, you guys, I want to stay on topic the best that we can. I understand that social media will be brought up, but I really would only like to talk about social media if it has to do with mindset. And then we can try to work through that maybe a little bit as well. But I really wanted to try to stick to that. And some of the things that I've been through on my journey with the online business, and some of the things that were really hard for me and challenging for me, and learning all of that, right? And after 35 plus years of working for somebody else, now I'm my own boss, right? And, you know, there's challenges with that too. Nothing is ever perfect. So mindset is going to be imperative. Self-motivation is going to be imperative with this and all the challenges that come along with it. If you're still working, you're trying to build your new business and all of the things, that's even when your mindset needs to be stronger than ever. You know, I was working two jobs and doing this. I knew nothing about any of it in the beginning, right? And I did that for 2.5 months. And I really had to be strong mentally in order to get through it. But I always kept my eye on the prize. I always kept that thought, the what if. But what if I can quit that job? What if I learn more and I start earning? You know, I always kept that right there. So I have some things that I make sure you got pen and paper so you guys can write some stuff down, some little tricks, some tips, all of the things that I've used to help me not only motivate myself, but to change some of the ways that I thought, the things that were holding me back. And look, I'm still not perfect, guys. Still not perfect. I still have my stuff, right? I'm a human. But it's something that I can acknowledge now. So let's get into it. Good. So I heard a quote today, right? And I thought, wow, this is a pretty, pretty cool quote. And I wanted to give it to you guys if you want to write it down. You will never be right if you're not willing to be wrong. I am telling you right now, when I heard that, I stopped in my tracks. See, because my past behavior was I was always right. I would argue to the death that I was right. Right? And I had to, yes, Michelle, let's go. Right? And I'll go to war. I'm right. I know I'm right. They don't know what they're talking about. They don't know, right? But I realized that held me back too. It has held me back in the past because I wasn't willing to be wrong and understand somebody else's perspective or the way somebody else thought or did something different, right? And along the way, I said, well, wait a minute. If I can learn from things that I've done wrong, a lesson, right? We learn from our lessons. Why can't I learn from being wrong? So by being wrong and accepting that I'm wrong about something makes me want to research why I was wrong. And by acknowledging that, that gives me power. It gives me more power than ever. And so often, your day, I want you to think about, am I trying to be right for no reason? Could I be wrong? And what can I learn from that? Because I know for so long I have held myself back from a lot of things. And along this journey of changing the way I thought and changing, you know, my behaviors and all of these things, I'm seeing that a lot of the times I had to be right. I had to be right. But it was to the detriment of me. I had to get out of my own way and accept that, yeah, maybe I was wrong in that moment. Okay, let me learn from it. What can I learn from that? So, do you guys, you know that old saying, first time, shame on them. Second time, shame on me. So sometimes we allow stuff, right? And that's okay. We'll, you know, let it go. But the second time we allow it? Think about that. There's a lot of things in life that we need to stop allowing. We need to draw that line and say, no, I'm not going to allow that anymore because it doesn't do me any service. It doesn't help me. Right? The last motivation, mindset motivation, I talked about putting yourself first. And for me, I never put myself first to the detriment again of myself. But once I started putting myself first, then I was able to take care of others because I knew I was still going to try to take care of everybody because that's me. But since I started putting myself first, I've been able to open a lot of doors. And this business is one of them. I would never have done this 2 years ago. Never. Right? I wasn't even on TikTok, but just say it. My daughter begged me for a year to get on TikTok and I wouldn't let her. And then I did, and I ended up with this business that has changed my life for the best thing, you know? So I want you to think about that, you know, learning from your mistakes and not always having to be right. It's okay to be wrong sometimes. Just learn. Learn from it. Take what you can away from it and learn. Okay. Added on to that. Recognizing our own behaviors. Do you find it hard to recognize your own behaviors and acknowledge when you may be the problem? Here's some tough love. Just gonna say it, right? Here's some tough love. I've been the problem in a lot of my scenarios. I was not willing to open my mind to something new. I was okay with being okay. I bitched about it. I complained about it. I hated everything about it. But I continued to stay right where I was because I had to be right. I didn't want to be uncomfortable. I wasn't willing to step out of my comfort zone. So I just stayed the course, even though I was miserable. So see, I was part of the problem, but I was not willing to accept that. I was unwilling to accept that I was the issue. It was the ex-husband. It was the boss. It was the lady that worked in the office. It was the guy at the hamburger joint. It was the lady at Walmart that was being rude, right? I was always doing one of those, pointing that way, and I forgot. Those other fingers were pointing right back at me. So, I ask you today, wholeheartedly, tough love. Are you willing to call yourself out on your own bullshit? Yeah? When you do, things will start to change for you. I can almost guarantee it. If you're perfect and you do nothing wrong and you're always right, how can anything ever change? It never will. So over a year ago, I put myself in my bathroom and I locked the door. For over 30 minutes, I screamed at myself. I yelled at myself. I called myself out for the last 20 years of all the crap that I allowed. All the excuses that I made for my own behavior. And I left it in that bathroom. And I said, no more. I am not going to allow myself to hold myself back anymore. I need to become the best version of me. And I have to let go of all the things that have been holding me back. So today, I want you to recognize, and going forward every day, I want you to recognize when you're not allowing yourself to be wrong. When you are in your own way, put the shoe on the other foot and say, well, maybe am I wrong? What can I learn from this? Instead of getting pissed off, putting it down, putting the phone down, don't look at the computer, whatever it is, whatever the instance is. Instead of walking away, asking yourself and acknowledging that maybe you're the problem and not the instance that you're getting upset with. Okay? With anything, especially for all you newer people, right? With anything, there's gonna be friction. There's gonna be things that you do not understand. That causes a little bit of tension, right? So find a way to say, I just don't understand it right this minute. I'm not going to get mad at whoever said it or did it. I'm not going to do X, Y, and Z. I'm going to walk away for an extended period of time, 20, 30, 40 minutes, an hour, 2 hours, whatever it may be. Come back with it with a fresh attitude. Because we tend to let things build up to our detriment, right? Okay. So, with that being said, do you feel like you're holding yourself back? It doesn't mean just in the online business. It doesn't mean in anything. Do you feel like, if you're being honest with yourself, do you feel like you're holding yourself back? And why? What are you afraid of? When you can acknowledge that you're holding yourself back, find out why. Figure it out. Figure out, why is it that I'm stuck where I'm at right now? Why is it that I'm holding myself back? Acknowledgement. Acknowledge, acknowledge, acknowledge. And that's really what this is about, is acknowledgement. You know, you've got to be able to call yourself out. And that was one of the biggest things that I started doing in this little transformation thing that I started, you know, I had to start calling myself out. And man, when I did, the list just kept growing and growing. I'm like, holy cow, I can't believe the amount of stuff that I've allowed myself to do by making excuses for my shitty behavior. It's the reason that I've held myself back. It's the reason that X, Y, and Z, whatever it was in that moment, you know? I still do stuff today, you guys. Come on. Nobody's perfect. But today I can recognize when I'm doing it. There's a difference, right? Okay. So, how can we change past behaviors that has held us back? We talked about first time shame on them, second time shame on us, right? Allowing others to hold us back, or allowing others to contradict what we want to do or what have you, right? The biggest thing is acknowledgement. The second thing would be acknowledging it. When you acknowledge that behavior and you sit in it, that's when you can call yourself out on, right? So I want you to write down, and I want you in that moment, I want you to ask yourself these couple of things. Start by writing down, do I make excuses for myself? Do I quit too quickly and never finish something? Do I hold myself back because of fear or failure? So do I make excuses? Do I quit too quickly? Never finishing anything? And do I hold myself back because of fear of failure? By a raise of hands in your camera, how many of you have held yourself back for fear of failure? I kind of figured that, right? How many of you, by the raise of hands, have quit something too quickly only to never finish it? And then be so disappointed in yourself, right? So, let me get this back over here. Okay, there we go. I want to bring something to mention. Do you remember this last job you had? Do you remember when you walked into that job? Did you know how to do that job? The way that office or that facility or that whatever wanted you to do that specific job? No, right? Everybody has their way of doing things. So what makes you think that you're going to have all the answers about this business? What makes you think that you're just going to start and you're going to blast off and everything's just going to be perfect, hunky-dory, and you're going to be a millionaire in a couple months? Right? See, I had no preconceived notion that I was going to be a millionaire in a couple months. I didn't even think I could quit one job in 3 years. I was willing just to learn, right? I was willing just to learn. So just remember, think back about any job that you've ever had or anything that you've done new. You've had to come into it with no knowledge. You've had to train. You've had to learn. And then you add a little bit more and a little bit more. And then the longer that you've been employed at a specific place or whatever, the more knowledge you gained, the more jobs were added to, you know, your workload. Give yourself some grace. Yes, right? Give yourself some grace. It's okay not to know everything. Yes, yes, I love it. Okay, step by step, take it day by day. Be patient with yourself. If you feel like you're frustrated, get up and walk away for a little bit. Get off of social media for a little bit. Have grace for yourself. Okay? Now, I got a little thing that you guys can do, and it's something that I've used for many, many months. Okay? Every single day, I have a couple words that I start my day out with. Okay? And I'm willing to share that with you. And I would love to hear how it works for you. Okay? So, every single day, I use these words. So, Monday, I use the words, I will. Now, let me explain this, and then you'll understand. So instead of on Mondays, every time I start to say, I can't or I won't, I change that to, I will. So the theme of Monday is, I will. And I stick to that theme every Monday. That has really, really helped, right? I will not quit. I will go live. I will ask a question today. Whatever it is for you, right? Everybody has different I wills. That's my Monday. Tuesday, I can. So every time the words I can't or, oh, that's not going to work for me, I change it to I can. Every Tuesday, all day long, I change my I can't to I can. I can go live. I can create that video that I've been dreading. I can whatever for Tuesdays. Okay? Wednesday, no more. No more bad behavior. No more making excuses. Okay? All day long. Thursdays, I refuse it. When those negative people and past behaviors creep up on you on Thursday, you're going to say, I refuse it. I refuse to be mad. I refuse to let you talk to me like that. Whatever it is for you, all day long, I refuse it. If it doesn't bring you joy and happiness, and I know you guys have heard me say this, I refuse it. Okay? Friday. I draw the line. Fridays are all about freedom. every Friday, I draw the line on whatever comes up. Maybe it's somebody else's attitude. Maybe it's somebody else's negativity. Maybe it's my own attitude. And I say, nope, I'm drawing the line. Change your attitude, Amy, because it ain't going to happen today, sister. I draw the line on Fridays. It's Freedom Friday. Saturday, I earned it. I earned this. I earned that. Whatever it may be, tell yourself that. I earned this. I've busted my butt for 35 years. I've earned the right to be happy. I've earned it. Right? And Sunday, I deserve it. So really quickly, I'll go over them one more time. Monday, I will. Tuesday, I can. Wednesday, no more. Thursday, I refuse it. Friday, I draw the line. Saturday, I earned it. And Sunday, I deserve it. Try it. Please let me know how this works for you. And look, you don't have to use those specific ones. Change them if you want. But I am telling you, when I wake up and I, oh, it's Monday, I will go get that facial today. Or I will do X, Y, and Z. It helps me. It keeps me focused on all the things that I will do. And it helps me not letting the negativity sink in, the I won't. I won't be able to do that. Why do I even try? Right? Because that's my past behavior. That's the crap that I'm letting go of. The negativity, the down talking to myself. You can't do that. Why would you even try to do that? That's not something you can do. You know? Okay. Lastly, before I open up for questions, because I know questions are so important. These are a few things that I've implemented over the last year that I do every day. Okay? And you can make your own list, but I'll give you a few things that have really helped me. I take 30 minutes a day, whatever that time, whatever it is for you, first thing in the morning, in the evening, whatever works for you, take 30 minutes. And this is where you're going to draw the line to your kids, your spouse, your family, to anybody and everybody. You're going to draw the line and say, nope, this is my 30 minutes. Okay? Take a walk. By yourself, no cell phone, no earphones, nothing. Just you for 30 minutes. Okay? If you can't walk, I understand. Go sit outside in the backyard by yourself. No social media, no nothing. Nothing. Just you and yourself. Okay? Now, another thing. You can sit on the floor in a bedroom. Lock the door if you got kids. Go to the park. Drive 5 miles down the road. Sit on the side of the road. I don't care, right? For 30 minutes, just sit in peace by yourself. Maybe you've got an office. Maybe you've got a she shed or a he shed. And you can go out, yes. Find that inner peace. Now, if you want to add some little bit of calming music or, you know, meditation music, whatever for you, you know, that's okay. You know, but nothing too, not words or anything like that. Something very peaceful. Give yourself 30 minutes every single day to just be by yourself with yourself. Stretching, rubbing your arms, right? Rubbing your head, talking to yourself, whatever it may be. And in that 30 minutes, while you're reflecting, let go of all the bullshit that just happened. Let it go. Get rid of it. You are doing yourself no service by holding on to that crap. None. Because you're the only one that's going to pay for it. Let it go. No more. I refuse it. You cannot continue to carry all of that baggage to your new life. It gets heavy. You've carried that shit for long enough. Let it go. It doesn't belong in your new existence. Let it go. And the last thing I want you to do is at the end of that 30 minutes, I want you to tell yourself, I forgive you. I have had to forgive myself for a lot of things that I've held on to. Because I have blamed myself for a lot of things that I had no damn control over. When you can start forgiving yourself for the things that have been holding you back, you're going to get a lot lighter. Set that baggage down. Let it go. Let it go. Okay?